Greetings, dear viewer. Welcome back to the Twisted Nightmare Studio. Today I'm going to be talking about the much maligned Cleopatra from Netflix. Now, if you haven't heard about this debacle, let me explain. People are pissed off because Cleopatra is portrayed as black. Now, if you didn't understand the situation, you'd be like, well, that's just racism. That's just, you know, that's just stupidity. But in reality, people are pissed off for a good reason, because if it had been labeled as a fictional piece, it wouldn't have been a big deal, whatever, everybody has their own reimagining, but this is labeled as a documentary. Apparently, Jada Pinkett Smith and this lady's grandmother...
My grandmother saying to me, I don't care what they tell you in school, Cleopatra was black.
No better than archaeologists and other people who have studied Egyptian history their entire lives. Oh, and of course, how can we forget the fine people of Egypt, who the director said shouldn't have a problem with this? She is simply asking them to see themselves as African, as if that is a country with a set type of culture and skin color, and not an entire continent that is three times the size of the United States. When told that the Egyptian people had a problem with how she portrayed Cleopatra, she said she didn't have a problem with them taking issue because she, a woman who isn't African by any metric that I can find, but she's saying she knows better than actual African natives. Because you see, Egypt is a country in Africa. It is sheer hubris to think that you know better and have the right to change history just to suit your modern sensibilities. And naturally, when people complain, out comes the ists and phobes and bigot to call any criticism of the show into question so they don't have to actually face reality. Because let's face it, the people who made this do not live in the real world. Hell, she is calling the entire country of Egypt racist because they reject the fact that a woman who is known to be of Greek Macedonian heritage should be portrayed as in a documentary as black. But they are the racists because they reject the fact that their country, in their country, they know what the truth is. And the director has done nothing but basically bury her fingers in her ear and go, blah, 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 I'm rubber, you're glue, all the words bounce off me and they stick to you, blah, blah, blah. And she just cannot admit that she's got it wrong. I am so glad that people are starting to fight back against Hollyweird. For too damn long, they have been shitting out
the message
and ignoring what the people want. Movies are supposed to entertain us. Politics belong in Washington. This is the problem with Hollyweird hiring activists instead of actual qualified writers. The strike, which, given what they're asking for, is basically going to kill the industry, and I'm glad, I do believe that this one director proves just how egotistical and self-righteous some people can get, even while being completely wrong. I've known too many people who simply cannot admit that they've done anything wrong, and the fact that these people are losing money left and right makes me so happy. I love when woke shit gets rejected by the population at large, because it makes me have hope that there might be a way to steer the ship back to reality, where people can be able to admit that they've messed up, just relabel it as a fictional reimagining. But no, instead the usual suspects will flock to the director's side and spout the usual, racist did that, that's why it's bad. Instead of actually taking it the time to look at themselves and realize that they made a mistake. Admit it, move on. Actually tell stories about real black sub-Saharan African queens. There are plenty to choose from, but instead you take the easy route, take a well-known figure from history, simply race swap to claim that they are black, and when you catch flack for it, you deny point fingers at all the racists and bigots. Unfortunately, this has been a proven tactic that Hollyweird has, even though it never seems to actually work, but they keep doing it. It's really funny to see the trends and realize that they haven't learned yet.
You would think that Hollyweird would eventually figure it out that they are losing money by doing this, and eventually they would get their act together and change.
But instead, we get to watch this ship crash over and over again and slowly sink from all the holes. It's enough to make you sick and happy at the same time. So what do you think? Did you waste your time with this, or like me, did you realize just by the reactions to the show that the reaction from the creators of the show and all the usual flackies how they responded and realized that it was just going to be trash. See, most people don't care if you race swap a character. I don't remember anybody claiming that Samuel L. Jackson was cast as Nick Fury despite the original incarnation of Fury being a grizzled white guy. Hell, I didn't care, and I think Sam did a fine job as Nick Fury. So it isn't about race, it is about historical accuracy and the very Western culture way of trying to rewrite things to fit your modern ideals when you simply cannot look at history through the same lens because times change. But these people cannot accept that. That's why you get these shows that rewrite history and have a awkwardly diverse cast despite the fact that in time and history, once upon, they weren't nearly as diverse. So, let me know what you think in the comments, and thank you for visiting the Twisted Nightmare Studio.